welcome, dear listeners, to Feel Like Weezer. I need to do it again. I said Feel Like Weezer.
Feel Like Weezer.
Okay. Hello.
That's the number one rookie mistake. You don't know the name of the podcast.
Yeah.
You're so new to the podcast.
Okay. Hello and welcome, dear listeners, to Feels Like Weezer, the intermittently released podcast where at least two awesome middle-aged dudes talk about the entire catalog of Weezer.
I'm middle-aged? Damn it.
I don't know. How long do you expect to live?
Yeah, probably not much longer, actually.
With climate change? So, yeah. Don't Google climate change.
Yeah, I actually might be past middle age. Yeah. We'll see. It remains to be seen.
I'm sorry, I interrupted. You need to say who you are, right?
Yeah, I will say who I am. My name is Martin David Tapia, yours truly. I'm an amateur musician and songwriter of little consequence, and I'll be one of your co-hosts for this episode.
And I'm the second co-host today, Eric Nash, and you can hear me also on Almost Famous Minute.
And we've got a guest today, right?
Yeah.
Are you here, guest? Who are you? Tell us about yourself.
Hi, my name is Dylan Gallagher. I am an administrator over at Weezerpedia under the username HMC, and I also run the YouTube channel Weezer B-Sides.
Wow, super cool. Thanks for being here.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
How are you doing today, Dylan?
Pretty darn good. As of the day we're recording this, Rivers Cuomo just dropped yet another bundle of old demos, so... You know, it's exciting and also infuriating to keep up with, but it's an
so
exciting
much.
Time.
Yeah.
It is so much. And he keeps, like, someone had to write a script to, like, scrape the website so that we would see, like, when he adds stuff and when he takes stuff away, even more importantly. So, and he just recently added folders a couple days ago, making it even more difficult to, like, okay, I gotta download the entire archive again, gotta... It's a nightmare, but it's a good problem to have, I think.
So I see why you're knowledgeable about this, because you have to handle that for the website.
Yeah,
I had not thought of that.
And fortunately,
man,
in light of all these demos coming out, a lot more people are coming out of the woodwork and helping with the wiki, and we just launched we have a Discord now. It's linked currently as, I don't know if it still will be, but probably will be, linked at the top of Weezerpedia.com.
That's very cool. So today, right, Martin, is Peace?
Yeah, we're talking about Peace, track 5 from Make Believe.
More and more, I can't say no, so afraid of letting go. If there's something I can grab, you can bet I'll pay.
So, Eric.
Yes.
What do you think about Peace?
I think Peace is kind of like Hold Me Part 2. we just did Hold Me last month, maybe-ish, whatever. It just seems so similar in this kind of a little bit plodding. You know, neither of these are definitely not bops, as the kids like to say, you know, as we've been saying a lot throughout the course of this show so far for the past year or what have you.
But, yeah, I think it depends on how you define bop. I think there's a wider definition of bop that you could fit into.
Where this could fit in?
I would say it's possible.
I think plotting is the right word. I think
Thank
you. Fully there. One third of this song is outro. So yeah. it just kind of keeps going.
Yeah.
You're like, every time you think like, oh, this is the end, right? And then he brings in another, whoa, and it's like, oh, no, another one, huh?
Okay. It's Weezer's Hey Jude.
Yeah.
Well, maybe whoa, I'm going to be a little bit.
Nah, nah.
Yeah, I'm going to be maybe a little bit more charitable. I would classify it, instead of plotting, I would say it's mid-tempo.
Yeah.
But maybe those.
Oh, you all fancy with your music words. You being the resident musician now.
Yeah, I guess so. But anyway, I interrupted you. What were you going to say?
No, I was for initial thoughts. I mean, I'm saying this stuff, and I'm not saying I don't like it. You know, I do have some, you know, liking towards it, you know. it's kind of, for roughly that third or half of it, it is kind of this nice calming kind of a song that's nice to have, not all like the Green Album pop punk songs.
That's a great pull quote. Eric Nash, I have some liking.
I like that too.
So Dylan, I'll throw to you now. Yes.
Yeah.
What do you think, Dylan?
It's fine. It's, you know, if in the whole of the Weezer canon, it's like not great, but it's not offensive. It's just kind of it's very middle of the road. And as far as make-believe songs go, if we're grading on that curve, I think it's pretty good. I think the album as a whole is not great. And this one is, you know, it's serviceable. I like it better than a lot of the songs on that album. So, and it, you know, it's had an interesting trajectory in terms of how it was originally demoed. It was a completely different song.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It was kind of a reggae-ish song, and then it became not that at all.
For the reggae-ish, are you talking about the Hey Domingo?
I'm talking about Hey Domingo, which was demoed in 2002, and it's kind of just a reggae-ish like guitar beat with the and that song somehow became Peace. We don't have the complete Fossil record, unfortunately.
There are some missing links.
Yeah, I mean, you would have thought it'd be one of the demos released recently, but as of the day we're recording this, it has not surfaced yet. Even though we have seen some Fossil record, like it's unfortunate that you guys had already recorded. This is such a pity, because now we know exactly how that got from She Who Is Militant to This Is Such a Pity, two completely different songs that don't sound anything alike, but, you know, just that germ of a chord progression just, you know, was reworked until it became something completely different. So it's hard to really see how you, like, listening to them separately, you wouldn't, you know, guess that Hey Domingo and Peace were related at all. But I think Peace is, like, main riff is kind of just like a slowed down version of the Hey Domingo riff. I think that's, I think it's just like a similar chord progression and not much else.
Cool. Wow.
So now we need to hear from Martin, right?
Yeah. I like this song, but, I like Make Believe, and in stark contrast to Dylan, I, am very new to this album. I think before I knew that I was going to be hosting this podcast, I might have listened to the whole album front to back maybe once or twice in my life. But in the last few weeks, I've been listening to it nonstop, and I'm really liking Make Believe. It's rising meteorically in my rankings, in my personal estimation. I would say, yeah, I would classify it as meteoric, a rise. Absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah, and I really like, I'm going to have to listen to that Hey Domingo. I also just, got the demo pack of the Make Believe demos, And I'm just focusing on that because that's what I'm trying to cram into my brain right now.
Yeah.
But
fortunately, a lot of those songs are the same song, just with different lyrics.
Yeah, that's what I've been been finding. But it's definitely super interesting to listen to, and I can't wait to dig in more later on. But yeah, I'd be interested because I really like especially the opening, like, descending guitar melody, that da-na-na-na-na-na. I think that's, like, a nice, peaceful little melody, and it makes me feel good, man. Yeah, and furthermore, I have more to say. Do you want to hear what else? I'm going to tell you.
Go on.
I'm not even going to wait. Oh,
sure. I'll just crack open a cold one here and then go on.
Yeah. Chug, chug, chug. Or just shrink at whatever pace you feel comfortable with. But yeah, the song actually, like, the lyrics, if you take them by themselves, are kind of stressful, I would say. I don't know. I get stressed out by them.
Interesting. So, that's not a take I would expect.
You don't find them stressful? I don't know.
The, like, lyrics to Peace stressful?
Huh? Yeah, like, all these problems on my mind make it hard for me to think. And there's no way that I can stop. My poor brain is going to pop.
Okay.
Yeah, that might be the verse that's the most, maybe. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think my thing with Make Believe is that even the songs that I like on the album, I think the lyrics are the absolute nadir of Rivers Cuomo's career, this entire album. Just every lyric, I think, just seems really, really insipid. Like,
yeah,
my poor brain is gonna pop is like, not this guy wrote Pinkerton and the Blue Album, like, how did we get here? Like, you know, even like, you know, I think Perfect Situation is a great song. I think This Is Such a Pity is a great song, but the lyrics aren't great shakes. Like, it's not what this album has going for it.
Yeah, I think that's true for sure. I think it seems like, and maybe this is like a charitable interpretation, but that all the lyrics are, like, intentionally very simple. Does it seem like that to you? Like, it seems like, not like Rivers was going for, like, the best or, like, the most in-depth lyrics that he could write. They seem, like, intentionally kind of
Yeah, we're still, like,
I don't want to say dumbed down, but
we're still in the aftermath of Pinkerton, which that entire era in Rivers' life, I think the commercial failure of that album kind of broke his brain for several years.
Yeah. Absolutely, I would say. It seems like it.
After that, you know, in the ensuing years, was just trying to chase this, you know, this pop formula and this, you know, this, like, you know, structure to songs. And I think it was to his detriment.
Well, now you've both mentioned the lyric, that last line of the verse to my poor brain. Now I immediately think of that as a song title by the Foo Fighters. So, I mean, you know, and that it definitely came out like 5-ish years prior to this. So, you know, it was interesting that he chose that line, you know. I mean, I think it's important. I mean, maybe he could have used a different adjective besides poor. For those of us that are familiar with Foo Fighters.
Weezer toured with the Foo Fighters the year that this album came out the Foozer tour.
Yeah.
It's not a complete leap.
Yeah, I think maybe it is actually a direct quote because
could be.
They seem to, like, in some interviews that I've seen, they've seemed to talk about each other a lot, especially like on the Foozer tour, right? Mm-hmm. Wait, did they ever decide if it was Foozer or the Wii Fighters? Anywho, And then, like, I saw some interview where Rivers was saying that, like, the band that they had a feud with was the Foo Fighters. I guess that was probably, like, a tongue-in-cheek thing.
But... yeah.
I mean, like, the song Knockdown Dragout was, like, that that title is a, like, a Green Day reference.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we definitely mentioned that back.
I have a question for Eric. Mm-hmm. If you're ready for to answer a question, I hate to put you on a spot, but I think you can answer.
I'll do my best.
It's about the word pop. Do you call soda pop?
I generally if I'm conscious of it, I will just go ahead and say both words.
I'll say soda pop.
Oh, see, I don't like that.
But when I slip, I think I generally say pop more than soda.
I started saying it ever since I moved to the Northeast Ohio area.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Just to fit in because, you know, I want to feel like I belong to something. And that something is people who say pop instead of soda.
It's a big issue. And then there's also the people that just call everything Coke. That grinds my gears more than...
Yeah, the less said about those people, the better.
Soda or pop, yeah. Yeah,
I live in Michigan, and I grew up saying pop, but I have a lot. So many of my friends are like from the East Coast and say soda, and they just sort of, you know, their influence just sort of infected me, and I've said soda for probably the last, you know, decade or more.
I'm glad we got to the bottom of that. Yeah, and speaking of the lyrics. I guess if we want to get back to talking about the song, I would say, like, what would you say is the chorus of this song? Because the part that I think of the chorus, yeah, exactly, it doesn't even have lyrics, right?
It's just whoa, 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 which is also the chorus to Perfect Situation.
Well, exactly.
No, I actually grab my lyrics from, instead of just Weezerpedia, I mean, I'll look at those, but I actually grab them and bring them into my Google Doc from Genius, and they list, you know, verse one is the more and more blah blah blah, I'll pay the tab. Chorus one, kind of all flowers, I need to find some peace, you know, verse two, then a chorus two that's a different lyrics, but it's I think they'll do that when they they'll go with whatever is the first stanza. If all the stanzas are different, essentially, they'll go with the first one being the verse, and then the second thing being the chorus, and they'll just call it chorus one. And instead of a repeating chorus, you know, and then they list the woes as a post chorus.
Oh, okay. Yeah. If I were doing it, and obviously, I mean, who am I? But I would classify, like, the parts with the lyrics, like the all the broken tethers part or whatever, as a pre-chorus. And then I would say the oh, 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 whoa, 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 I would classify that as the chorus.
Mm-hmm. I can't stand having all of those, like, post-chorus, chorus. I can't stand having that in my lyrics. If I ever see that on Weezerpedia, I just delete that.
I support you. That seems like
I may be editorializing, but I think it's too messy.
Yeah, it's okay. Nobody's completely impartial. We all have our own biases, Dylan, and it's okay. It's all right. I'm gonna say some more about this song. I like the rhythm. I wanted to describe it as a lilting shuffle. I don't even know if that's a good way to describe it.
I don't know
it.
If that's completely accurate, but I do like that phrasing just in general. I like the aesthetics of that term.
Yeah, this made me think of, this is weird, but like there was a, like in the early 2000s, there was a Beach Boys, like, a compilation album that came out that, like, Brian Wilson picked, like, 19 Beach Boys songs or something, and in the liner notes there was, like, he wrote a little description of each song and why he chose them or whatever. There's a song called Sail On Sailor from like one of the Beach Boys, like later, like not that later, but like 70s albums or whatever, Holland. And he says, I really like how this song rocks. And I think it has like an exclamation point. And for some reason, like that phrasing really sticks with me. I think it's really funny because if anybody who's listening knows the song Sail on Sailor, or if either of you know the song, like it doesn't rock in the way that we would think of like a song rocking. Like it's like this really corny, like 6/8 beat kind of thing. And it, I just think it's like a really silly way to describe. I don't know. It's just something funny that only Brian. I don't know. Brian Wilson's like a very specific guy or whatever. So I like the way this song rocks. Okay, that's what I'm trying to tell you.
I came across on a certain website Rivers and the other band members also talking about the song, but. The way Rivers ends this one kind of thought he's having, he says, so the song is actually not coming from a place of peace at all. And, you know, I read that, I'm like, huh? I mean, I read the stuff previous to that, and I was following him, but then when he gets to that point, that final point.
His brain is going to pop, dude. He's, of course he's not.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to say earlier. Like, it seems like these lyrics are super stressful to me. Like, even if we want to say the pre-chorus or what the chorus, like, that seems kind of stressful, too. Like, even counting all the flowers, waste the precious hours, like, you're wasting those hours. Mm-hmm. It seems like, it makes it seem like counting the flowers isn't worth the time. It's a waste, right? But then when you get to the actual chorus or whatever you want to call the whoa, whoa, whoa part, like that's like the peaceful part, I would say, because there are no more lyrics. It's just like, whoa, 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 whoa.
but then the thing is though, with that statement of his prior to that, like one of the things he was referencing was like, you know, the hippies of the 60s. And so my kind of note was, you know, that they weren't, you know, kind of not coming from what they were actually doing. They weren't coming from a place of peace of, you know, where they were coming from wasn't peaceful, but that's what they wanted though. But they weren't coming from a place of peace, the hippies. You know, because, I mean, the reason they were doing what they were doing was because there was this huge war and there were the civil rights issues, you know, they were trying to help and nudge along, you know, and progress, what have you. And then my final note on this was that the big difference is that that was this very external thing then in the 60s. But for the song and what Rivers seems to be talking about, I think is all so much more internal. You know, it's all about like you're saying, like, you know, it, you know, my poor brain, the, you know, it's in his head, these things that are in his head and stuff like that, or maybe just even some other things, you know, that are of a more personal nature or interpersonal, really, you know, with just one other person, usually a girl.
Yeah, Rivers was. This is the first album that they released after he started meditating.
Okay.
Rick Rubin, who produced the album, was the guy that introduced him to meditation. Because his life was just kind of like Rivers' life was kind of just falling apart. I think before that, like Maladroit was kind of just, I think, the nadir, like, you know, getting sued. He's not, you know, he's kind of in a creative tailspin. The song, I guess, makes sense in that context. You can kind of read into it in that way, I think.
Yeah, I would say so. All right, so do we have anything else to say about peace?
There is the one little segment that I've been doing more and more lately.
Oh yeah, give me the left ear, right ear. Left channel.
Right channel, left channel, right channel, left channel, right channel, what is it gonna be? Eric Nash has some information for
excellent piece of music, by the way. But so yeah, so
thank you.
So for this song, the biggest thing I noticed is that it's obvious. I think both channels have acoustic guitar strumming going on in them,
but they are separate guitars.
What's that? But what I noticed is that
we've cracked the code
on the right side. I think it's like a bit of a brighter tone. It's also that maybe they both kind of have a bit of a different strumming pattern going on at points, at least. Not necessarily all the time. Different are all the time the same, that's for sure. But like I said, the right side a bit of a brighter tone. The left side it kind of has that, you know, it's a little bit of a muting. I think that's probably that might be happening or it's just maybe it could be the difference of a, you know, well, I mean, I think you get the brighter tone possibly from different acoustic guitars. Would you say that's might be the case, Martin?
It's certainly possible. You know. I'm not much of a musician. I know I said I'm a musician, but I don't know anything about guitars or anything like that. Okay.
Well, if it's not necessarily different acoustic guitars, or I mean, you know, it's possible it's even one's acoustic, one's electric, but one is brighter. That's an electric, just, you know, set on, you know, the amp and effects set to kind of simulate acoustic. Could be how that's happening.
It seems possible.
Yeah.
Perhaps even likely.
Yeah. And then the only other thing is during those woes for the chorus, post-chorus, whatever we want to call it, but during those woe sections, you know, the right side definitely amps up, I think with more distortion there on the right side, and that kind of really smothers out that acoustic. The acoustic gets really faded into the background during those sections. But comes right back when it goes away and as it outros, definitely.
This has been the Left Channel, Right Channel Report
with Derek Nash.
Yes, great segment. Once again,
thank you.
You talked about what's in the left channel, what's in the right channel. Great segment. What other segments do we have, Eric?
Well, I also often, I'll talk about for Rocksmith that, you know, well, actually, as of a few months ago, I didn't check recently, but as of a few months ago, there were no even in the CDLC, the custom downloadable content that's available. There was no efforts made by anyone that supplies for that game, learning game, any versions of this song, unfortunately.
Very sad.
There is a song, and that's a fact. Now tell me who has covered that. Who has covered that song? Who has covered that song? Let's talk about covers.
And then there's a good old cover segment, which really the only thing I got for that is besides, you know, several people, you know, and even a couple people together in a couple instances, you know, kind of casually in somewhere in their house, you know, in living room or something, seemingly probably playing along to the song more likely, but maybe not for the couple people especially. But there's definitely I did listen to all the way through to this time to the Weezer cover project, which is the acoustic guitar only, no lyric, vocals even for that.
I really like their takes on Maladroit songs. It's kind of interesting. Like, you wouldn't think it'd be interesting to hear acoustic renditions of Maladroit, but I thought they were kind of interesting.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't find any covers of Peace, really. There is apparently a cover from the album6.com Bordy tribute album, but I can't find that album anywhere. Wow. I can find every other album that... they did since then. That's the forum that is now allthingsweezer.com. But I can't find the original tribute album anywhere. So if anyone knows, please let me know.
We talked about covers. We talked about covers. We talked about covers.
Yeah. If you have that information, call in. Just yell into your device. You should get through.
You can contact me on my YouTube channel at youtube.com/channel/UC, the number 2. Just look it up. Just look up Weezer.
Great. Hey, I have a question. what brings you guys peace?
What brings us peace in the abstract?
Yeah, in a personal way. Like, what things do you find peaceful? What brings you the most peace, Dylan?
Honestly, and this is not a joke, editing Weezerpedia has been, like, a very zen hobby for me. Like, especially with all just the fucking shit going on in the world in general. Yeah. Like, being able to just plug into that and just to be able to plug into something that does not fucking matter at all is so, like, enriching to me, I have found. It's cool. I enjoy it.
Yeah, I think that comes through on the Weezerpedia. I find it to be a zen, yeah, very peaceful. How about you, Eric?
For me, let's keep it really on topic here. Listening to podcasts, but not all the ones that I listen to, because generally earlier in the day I'll listen to slightly heavier, more political based ones. Mm-hmm. So the later in the day, non-political, just much more entertainment, you know, fun and music related and different things like that. Podcasts I listen to that, and it's usually at work, and hopefully by that point of the day, I've taken care of all the emails that came in overnight. I'm just kind of sitting there, kind of drawing a bit more.
Cool. I was just curious. I just wanted to know mm-hmm. this information.
Because you don't have anything that brings you peace, or do you?
I have no moment of peace. My poor brain is gonna pop. Yeah, it's just always. I'm always on edge.
Just chaos.
Yep. I'm screaming internally right now.
Just the one little straw will break your camel's back, right?
True. Yeah. All right. Do we have anything else to say?
I don't think so. So, Dylan, do you have anything?
About the song? Not for the song, really.
So I think we should go to rankings. Ratings? Rankings? What is it? Ratings.
I say ratings. Yeah. But we could say either.
Well, we eventually, what we do, Martin, I don't know if you've listened to, as you've been trying to listen to our back catalog thus far, when we get to the overall album at the end episode, that's when we then rank the songs
from
the
albums.
So yeah, so this is
so
just
today
the
we're
this
rating.
Is just the rating. Part.
But in the future, we will be ranking.
Yeah.
All right, very good. Dylan, mm-hmm. how do you rate this song on a scale of 0 to 10?
On a scale of 0 to 10 on this base 11 numbering system, I would give this a 5. I think it is squarely middle of the road. It doesn't offend me. It's somewhat pleasant, but I probably will not seek it out for a while. Like, I listened to it a bunch in preparation for this podcast, and it's probably going to be a while before I, you know, feel the desire to listen to it again.
Well, I think that's a great rating.
It's serviceable.
Yeah,
I think it's a fantastic rating. I'm here for it. Hey, Eric.
Yeah.
What about you?
Well, wait until you get a kick out of my rating, because I'll give it a 6.25.
Wow, I don't want to say it's a better rating, because all ratings are valid and beautiful in my eyes, but...
Please justify every decimal point.
Well, I had to give it something lower, I feel like, than my second rating for Beverly Hills. So...
I think I haven't listened to both Beverly Hills episodes. Did you rank it differently each
yes.
time?
Yeah.
Okay, very good. I like that.
Both Zach and I each gave different ratings. And we had different guests the first, you know, between the one time.
That, you know what? That's all right. Reviewing anything is just where your head is at the time that you're reviewing it. That goes for any kind of review of any kind for any medium, whether it's music, whether it's film, whether it's video games. It's just a frozen in time, like, you know, survey of where the reviewer's head is at that moment. You can't, like, you know, you can't boil it down to a science.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. So Martin, you need to put a number to this song now.
Yeah.
Non-scientifically.
Okay. I had a whole scientific explanation. It was a lot of technical mumbo-jumbo, but I'm actually just going to toss that out and follow my heart and give this song a 9.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, because I really like it. I really like this entire album. I think I said that up front in the beginning of the episode. But I want to give it a 10 because I kind of like all of the songs, but I have to... There have to be tiers, right? Can't just give everything a 10 or else, like, 10 doesn't mean anything, right?
Martin wasn't on the show for the Blue album in Pinkerton, so this is his scale is all out of whack.
Yeah.
Yeah. But these are all relative to make-believe. Well, okay, I don't want to say that. It's relative to all songs in the universe. So
you must compare it to every song individually that ever has ever existed. You can't. Otherwise, you're a hypocrite.
Yeah, for sure. When I started doing, or when I found out that I was going to be co-hosting the podcast, I started, like, writing down every Weezer song. And I like, cut out, like, little pieces of paper, like an insane person.
God.
And it was, like, trying to rank them all. I couldn't do it. It was
dude, I'm going to have to, like, be the one that edits the list of Rivers Cuomo songs now that we've had all these demos. And I'm not looking forward to that. It's going to take a while.
Well, it seems like we've said a lot about this song, Peace.
Yeah.
And I would say, potentially, we've said enough.
There's only so much you can say about this song, I feel like.
Yeah, maybe. There's only so much you can say about any subject, really.
Yeah, but especially peace.
Yeah, so I think we want to find out from Dylan do you want people to find you? You've already gave out a little bit of... You know, projects are, you know, the big one, Weezerpedia.
Is it plug time? Okay. Yeah. My name is Dylan Gallagher. I'm on Weezerpedia under the username HMC. I'm an admin over there. You should just check out Weezerpedia in general because I spend a lot of time of my life working on it. And so do a lot of other people. I also run the YouTube channel Weezer B-Sides. If you just search it on YouTube, you will probably find it. You can follow me on Twitter if you want to at Ain't No Fun Time, and you can check out my artwork on dylangallagher.com. That's DYLANGALL, or no, it's not that. It's dylangart.com, DYLANGART.com. I couldn't get the dylangallagher.com. That was already taken, unfortunately.
Aww. I'm going to look it up. I love art. Art so good.
I've been Eric Nash. You can find me. My first podcast was Watchmen Minute, and second one currently ongoing is Almost Famous Minute. They're both parts of, they're in the format of the Movie by Minute, which this what we're doing here is kind of a cousin to Song by Song. But both Almost Famous Minute and Feels Like Weezer here are part of Pantheon Podcasts, and you can find a whole 60 or more shows probably at the time this comes out, all rock and roll, or mostly rock and roll, some other music, genres, what have you, there are some podcasts for there, too. But you can find them all at pantheonpodcast.com. And, you know, we have our Facebook and Twitter. You know, definitely try and, you know, go about finding those and liking and following them. The Facebook is facebook.com/feelslikeweezer. And our Twitter is @feelslikeweezer.
Oh, that makes sense.
Facebook-wise, we also have our Facebook-wise, group-wise, we have our Feels Like Weezer Listener Society. And that's probably the best place to go and have deep, meaningful conversations versus your shorter ones.
Yeah, if you think you have more to say about peace, yeah. Check out the Feels Like Weezer Listener Society and let your voice be heard in a digital way. I'm going to try to post a video when this episode comes out of myself covering this song. I'm going to try to do this for every episode that we put out. So,
you already did it once for an episode for our most recent episode where you actually weren't even on yet, but the episode came out since, you know, we'd started recording with you.
Yeah, it's difficult to parse. Time is a construct, so...
Yes.
Yeah. Anyhow, my name has been and remains always, unless I change it, Martin David Tapia. If you are really interested in pursuing more of something else that I've done, I'm in a band called Yoid. That's Y-O-I-D. We're a band with, I'm one of 11 guitar players.
What?
And, yeah. And we don't have any recordings, but maybe if you put it into your Google machine, some kind of video would come up. And you could watch that. So yeah, check out the band Yoid, or right now we're in the middle of a coronavirus, but when there is live music again, maybe... check your local listings. We may be playing in your town. And so as the sun rises in the east and sets in the west, so comes to an end another episode of the Feels Like Weezer podcast.
Bad ending.
Pray love, bitches.